Hello friends, it's Vanda here. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I hope you all doing great. So today I'm going to discuss about listening. We have done summarize spoken text and write from dictation in previous videos. If you haven't watched it, please go and watch those videos because it is really helpful. It will give you insight how to do summarize spoken text and how to attempt write from dictation. Apart from this, I'm providing online coaching classes. One-on-one session. Many students, got benefit from one-on-one session. Apart from this, we also provide exam-oriented material, plus 100% proved methods. Most importantly, the feedback you get, in the class, that can really make a difference, which can help you to get good score on your PT exam. So I would highly recommend that you should consider taking one-on-one sessions if you are struggling to get your score in PT. Okay, we have lots of success stories. You can visit our Facebook page and you can see and then trust and then enroll in the classes. Alright, so having said that, I'm going to start today's video. We have done summarized spoken text so far and we have done write from dictation so far. So today I'm going to discuss fill in the blanks. Which is very important task of listening module, and in the next video I will discuss highlight correct summary, which is also very important task, and multiple choice, choose multiple answers, multiple choice, choose single answer, select missing word and highlight incorrect word. These tasks I leave upon you that you're going to do by yourself because these are really easy tasks and there's no fixed strategy to actually do this task. So I would say you can do this task with practice. Get the recent exam questions and do practice as much as you can. I won't say that leave this question in the exam, attempt it, but these questions having least importance in this listening module. Okay, so let's start filling the blanks. In the exam, you get 2 to 3 questions in the exam, and listening and writing skills are assessed. 2 to 3 questions in the exam, such as you will get a paragraph with the 4 to 5 fill in the blank like this. Okay, we'll discuss in further slide. This is just basic things, I'm just letting you know. So you have to fill that blank with the right spelling. Okay, if you get one spelling right, you get one score for listening as well as for writing. At least 10 plus score you get from listening here. 10 plus score, and I would say pay attention on the words which are ending with s or es or ed, because some words ending with ed like divided, perceived, processes, sometimes you miss s, es or ed, which can cost you a lot of scores. So I would highly suggest you to pay attention on the words which are ending with s, es or ed, and keep in mind that its score goes into writing as well. Okay, so see some important strategies I will discuss today so that you can tackle this task successfully. There will be 7 seconds before the audio starts. So you please read the transcript carefully before the audio starts, because it will give you an idea like what you're going to hear. What are you going to listen? And you have to follow the speaker. Please, your eyes should be on the transcript and ears open to the idea. One thing more, that your cursor should move according to the audio. Don't mess it up that you get so busy in writing you forgot there is audio is happening right there. So you just keep your eyes on the transcript and ears open to the audio, and be ready to write in the rough notepad. And I would say use tab button to move between gaps. They are filling the blanks like that, and you can save your time by clicking the tab button, because from the one filling the blanks, you can jump to the next. You can jump to the next with the tab button, and once you complete that paragraph with your answers, so review in the end whatever the answer you have written that makes any sense or not. That's very important. And please, time management in listening is very, very important. don't spend a lot of time, don't think, you know, going answers, like, don't think that you can recall the answers. Whatever you have written, then just write confidently in filling the blanks. That's the only thing you can do at that moment. We're gonna do an example right now, which will give you clear insight how this task works. Okay.
George Black, a well-educated Englishman, was editor of the Diggers Advocate. Through his paper, he worked to form the Diggers into a cohesive group which would resist oppressive laws. A Welshman, John Bison Humphrey, took the conservative view and believed the solution should be gained by constitutional means. The most picturesque personality among the leaders was an Italian, Raffaello Carboni, and it is to his dynamic and emotional narrative that we owe much of the detail of those bitter days. The sixth man, Timothy Hayes, was an Irishman and a rousing speaker.
Okay, have you noticed that how I move the cursor along the audio? Okay, so you have to do the same. You just need to listen to the particular word, which is very, very important. Don't write whole, you know, whole transcript, whole audio, whatever you're hearing. Just focus on the word which you have to fill the gap. Okay, so let's see the answers. First was cohesive, second was conservative, third is picturesque, fourth is rousing. I hope you got the answers right. Okay, if you haven't, then you really need to practice a lot. This task is not that difficult. This task is very easy. You get comfortable if you do a lot of practice in this task. Find out the recent exam questions and just practice. Practice the, you know, writing right spellings, because if you get one spelling right, you get one mark. Okay, so this is very important that you practice spellings, right spellings. Okay, so this is the answer of the audio which you just heard. So these are the mistakes which you should avoid. Please do not leave any blanks unanswered, because there is no negative marking. So I would say you know, take a guess if you are unsure. Agar aap, you know, if you are unsure, then you can definitely guess according to the paragraph. If you understand that paragraph, then you can write any word. Avoid using full spellings when you are taking notes. While listening to the audio, you can fix the spelling once the recording is over. Once you are listening to audio, please, you can write, like, for example, you heard a table. Sorry about my writing. So you can just write notes like TBL, table. Okay, once when you writing in those gaps, when you typing especially, then you can write table. But once you are taking notes, you can use short forms. These days people are very smart. They use texting lot like on their phones, and they are used to this thing because they use short forms and they can use this smart thing in their paper as well. So don't waste time in revisiting your answers again and again. Please, this thing many students do, they don't have confidence, and they check their answers again and again. That doesn't make any difference. Once you heard, you heard. Okay, and time management is very important, so please don't waste time. Whatever you have written, then have some confidence and just write or just type the answers in the required gaps, and then click the next button to move to the next question. Okay, so this was a little small effort from me to you know, give you an idea how this task works. I hope you understood this task very well. If you didn't, please, you can comment me in comment section below, and I would answer your questions as much as I can. Apart from this, as I mentioned earlier, if you really need coaching classes, one-on-one session, personal attention or feedback, you can contact us. All right, So this was my video. Thank you so much for watching today. If you like it, you can hit the like button, share and subscribe our channel. Thank you so much. I will see you in my next video with the highlight characters, summary tips and tricks.